Thank you.
Whoops, sorry.
Very well, thank you.
Yeah, see?
I am right.
Thank you for having us.
Tom, Danny, that's me. Practice enough.
I am Tim.
Tim, nice to meet you.
Just one housekeeping item, I will be keeping time for you guys. You have 20 minutes at 15, get your cue going, I'll raise my hand. That'll give you five, you have 5 minutes left, and then we'll have 10 minutes for questions. Please begin.
Well, thank you all for having us. We're very excited for this presentation. Start off a little introduction from University of Arkansas Consulting, and my name is Madeline Negro.
I'm Paul Lowe.
I'm Daniel Sauer.
And I'm Alejandra Medellis.
A little overview of the agenda for today. We're first going to discuss the background, rural industry, and company knowledge that we wanted to highlight. Next is the situation with factors considered within this task. And then will be our goal and demonstration of the necessary criteria. After that will be the methodology on how we are solving this problem, and then our confident recommendation for you all. A little bit of background within the company. It's a very well-established company, as we understand. No driver issues with the driver shortage, and a lot of customer service priority, which we love that. Next is industry knowledge. We understand that intermodal is constantly growing each day. There's a high delivery expectation within customers, and we have heavy driver regulations. Our task contains three different factors within it. The first one being our lanes, all starting with Los Angeles, then ending in Chicago, Madison, Rochester, and Pittsburgh. We have three different equipment options, one being a 53 trailer, one being a 53 foot container with a chassis included, and then one being a 28 foot trailer. The next is within those, we have the locations of sorting facilities, terminals, and railroads. Our overall goal is to include the required service standard, our lowest cost, and the optimal equipment strategy. The methodology within our entire process includes starting with the research and reading and analyzing the information that will frame the problem. In order to solve the problem, we have tested several different route options to achieve the optimal cost, and we'll recommend our results for you. To start off, Pablo can help you out with lane one.
The first lane we have is to Chicago. Again, as we said, it will start in Los Angeles. And then travel to Chicago, whether it be on the highway, which is around 2,000 miles, or if it goes by rail, which again, it would be around 2,000 miles. And the packages that we need to deliver there are 8,000 packages. The recommendation we want to give y'all for this lane would be on rail. It's 453 containers. Total cost is $14,411.20. And the per package is $1.80. And what we did for the per package is we took the total cost, divided it by the amount of packages that are needed for that specific location. And then for this, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, that is as if the day zero starting and then changing as need be. There's no difference between all of them. They're all the same for this recommendation. And the cost analysis, as you can see, the gray area is the one we decided to choose with. It is the lowest cost. And if you look at the key down below, it shows four, and then the 53 container, that is the units of equipment per method of transportation. Second lane is LA to Madison. It is around 2,000 miles driving, and after it gets to Chicago, it'll be another 153 miles by miles driving, and it is 1,800 mile packages that needs to be delivered. For this one, we recommend driving it there using 153 container with one driver, total cost is $3,961.20 per package. And again, this is the recommendation Monday through Friday. There is no change from the day that changed from day zero. And here is, again, the orange mark. It is the lowest cost out of all of them. And with this, driving sometimes is more expensive, but it is the cheapest option, including the drivers, the cost, the sorting fees, everything that is included. It is the cheapest option for this one. Next, we have Daniel talking about Lane 3.
Some more information on Lane 3. The origin is Los Angeles, California, and the destination is Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Via highway from LA, it would be around 2,400 miles, and if we were to take it to a Chicago terminal, it would be 470 miles added on, and that has a demand of 4,000 packages daily. So before I do the recommendation, we actually have a different total cost. It's $9,958, but I'll show you later on the graphs. Our recommendation stays the same. It is 2 53-foot trailers through rail, which will switch over, coming off the rail immediately to the highway with one driver each, since it is under the 500-mile, 11-hour shift max, so it can make it there with one driver. And that is for pickup day Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Our second recommendation, which we found to be a little cheaper, is 2 53-foot containers on rail. And that will have the 12-hour sorting fee, but we will still make it within the 4-day delivery commitment. And that is the cost of $9,492.80, or $2.37 a package. And that is only for day Tuesday pickup. Here's a cost analysis for the no sorting on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. This is the actual number we will be looking at right here. It is a little more expensive than just driving straight from LA to Pittsburgh, but with the risk involved, and we weren't 100% sure that it would actually be able to meet that 4-day requirement, we went with a little bit more expensive one to actually use the rail, since they do prioritize our shipments. So we get it off Chicago, off on Chicago, and straight to Pittsburgh. Here's the cost analysis for the sorting one on Tuesday. It is the overall lowest option to just use two containers and transfer them to two trailers and do the one driver, like I said again, to Pittsburgh, since they are under the 500 mile limit from Chicago. And here is Alejandra to give you some information on Lane 4.
So for Lane 4, we have its destination is LA to Rochester, New York. It's a total distance from the sorting facility to the destination would be about 2,603. And if we use the terminal and then get it to from the gateway to destination, it's around 606 miles. And its total estimated demand of packages per day would be 1,800. Now, taking into account that there are different pickup days, we do have three different recommendations for this lane. The first one would be with pickup days on Monday, Thursday, and Friday. Our equipment would be 150-foot trailer, combined with 128 trailer. This would be on rail, and then once it hits the gateway, we would take it on highway with a team driver. This is so that way we can guarantee our delivery date. And our total cost would be a little bit over $10,000, with a per package price of about $4. We are able to sort that day. We're not able to sort that day. Sorry about that. On pickup day Wednesday, we would not be able to sort that day, but we do have a little bit of more time. Therefore, our equipment would still continue the same. It's the 153-foot trailer combined with the 28-foot trailer. But then once it hits the gateway, we can just use one driver, which will reduce the cost to $8,840. And the per package price would also drop a little bit by to $3.54. For this last pickup day, Tuesday, we would be able to sort since we have a little bit more time. And therefore, our equipment would change slightly. We would be using 153-foot container, still combined with 128-foot container trailer. And but once it hits the terminal, we would switch the container to a 53-foot trailer. And the 28 trailer would just continue to its destination. This total cost would be the per package around $342. Here is the cost analysis. This is a comparison for pickup days Monday, Thursday, and Friday. As you can see, the gray bar is the one that we are recommending. It is slightly higher than this one, but once again, we are choosing this because we want to make sure that we get it there on time. The next one, this is the day that we would have time to sort, and this is the day that we would begin with using a container and then switching it over to a trailer. And so you can see that this is our optimal cost at $8,553. And this would be another day that we would not be able to sort, but we would have a little bit more time. Therefore, we would just be using one driver in this one. So as you can see, it's the gray bar, and that one is the $8,842.
So to conclude our analysis, we made a quick summary here with our lanes, with our dedicated, our selected equipment and our total cost. You have an appendix with you. We thank you for allowing us to present this to you, and if you have any questions, we are open for them right now.
So do you have a total cost for, you have it by lane, but do you have one that, what's the total? All four.
So all four of them together?
We do not. We did not. We just did by lane, but we did not do them all together.
So y'all, real quickly, y'all have done a lot of work on this. I'm curious, what tool, what kind of modeling tool would y'all use to put together these different scenarios? Sure, we don't just cancel that. You must use some kind of.
Would you like to see them? I can show you. We did like a Excel.
Oh, just,
yeah.
Oh, this is it. It's just an Excel.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yes. Got it. Yes. I'm with y'all.
We just did the function and referencing it.
Yeah.
So if we change something on one side, it would change.
Okay.
The
so you did a bunch of iterations. Okay.
And then for different like qualitative, we decided to also use just different sheets so we can have everything in the same Excel file.
Okay.
We didn't have to keep transferring between Word or some other kind of file.
Okay. And y'all didn't use the least cost scenario in all cases. It would only be, you would spend a little bit more money to preserve the quality of the service.
Yes,
is that
correct.
Right?
Okay.
I do like how you did list every lane and every option and the cost for every option. So I think that I really like to see. And then you, if you made a deviance from that, you still showed, okay, yes, it was a lower cost, but it wasn't that much, or here's my reasoning for it. But if you know, if the mandate was just for the lowest cost, you could do that because you had it.
Yeah.
So thank you. That was good.
Appreciate it.
In consideration to save time, if you had to shave off a day, the way you figure it?
I'm sorry, could you?
To say, okay, you're focusing on a specific day, and you got it, how many days do you have to deliver before?
Mm-hmm.
If you had to take one day off, did you do that in consideration on if something happened?
On some of them, we had one driver, so we had an extension. So we would add a second driver, so we didn't have to stop and therefore cut back time. So on some of them, we could have, we did them out because we presented.
Does that answer your question?
Yes.
Can you go back to the difference for lane two? Just what was the Wisconsin, what was the price difference between rail and the direct truck?
This one or this one?
Yeah.
Yeah, so the rail one was including rail and highway. So instead of just driving straight from LA to Pittsburgh, because there's we even use Google Maps and just so many zones of construction. And so traffic jams, which is we didn't know if we weren't 100% sure if we could actually deliver the fourth day, so we went with the rail.
So where you used a container to transit to Chicago, and then you showed a trailer taking it beyond to the final destination, in your cost structure, I couldn't see the actual sortation costs and all the other costs going through Chicago. Can you show that to me again, please?
Right here is the...
Okay.
We have our
think if I have a pointer on that.
Does it have
a clicker?
Does it?
Yeah, so just walk me through this, if you don't mind.
Sure, so we have the rail costs, we have the equipment needed to fulfill the demand of the packages.
Yep.
We have the LA sorting, which would be the $70 fee to get it from the LA sorting to the rail.
Yep.
And so here, the terminal, this is just the cost of each container here. And then the gateway sorting facility, that's just the, is that the $25 fee per container to take it to Chicago sorting?
Yep.
And then the package handling, I believe, this is the 4,000 packages times 10 cents a package.
Got it.
So the 400 would be included into the total cost right here.
Yep.
And we just summed up the whole road to get the total right here.
I think the chassis in there too.
First time I've seen the chassis in there. Yeah.
And they got 3 days in there.
we consider it's a huge Excel sheet, but every single option we also mapped out every single day. So in some of those, for a time-wise, we could have done two drivers instead of one, or no container to take out the sorting options we could have done the days. It was an awful lot of Excel sheets for us. So this is our best way to summarize.
Yeah.
I also like the cost per package, too, like giving a breakdown of what each box is going to have.
We didn't do the total cost just because they were separated. We weren't sure if it was going to be all together or just different lanes.
In reality, you didn't have this information. Let's say you have one driver pulling a 28-footer from Chicago to New York. More than likely, Chicago being a hub, there would have been a second 28-footer, which would have reduced your cost on those lanes when you listed those single drivers. Just makes your scenario even better.
I think we're noticing for like stacking them on the rails even. Mm-hmm. The additional days is a little bit more cost reduction as the orders include.
Just a thought, when y'all get back to Fayetteville, you could literally sit down and total up what your costs are, and it'd be kind of fun to know that number. Because what we've seen so far is it's fairly tight. Really tight, in terms of what the total costs are. So it's, everybody's kind of coming in pretty close with different iterations of stuff.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you all.